When a conductor is moving in a magnetic field, then an EMF is induced according to Faraday's laws. Now, in our day-to-day life, there are so many examples of a conductor moving in a magnetic field. A very important thing is this direction. If this is magnetic field, this should be the force which is at right angle to it, and this should be the orientation of the conductor so that current flows in this direction. This makes XYZ axis. So magnetic field, velocity and the orientation of conductor for electric current, they should be at right angle to each other. This is required. Otherwise, there will be no EMF, because when we make EMF, it is d phi by dt. D by dt of phi. Phi is what? Phi is B A cos theta. And this theta is important. This is angle between the two. And by the way, if this theta is equal to 90 degree, then the whole thing will become zero. Area vector will be 90 degree. How? If this is magnetic field and this is conductor. This and the conductor is falling like this. It has area vector in this direction. This is magnetic field. This is the area vector, and they make right angle to each other. Now, if this is falling like this, the EMF induced will be zero. So, to remember this thing, that EMF will be made or it will not be made, just remember an example. That whenever a conductor is moving, it should be simply cutting the flux, magnetic field line. If it is cutting the flux, like we cut a vegetable with a knife, then only EMF is induced. You see, if we have a vegetable like this and we want to cut it, we have to put the orientation in this way. If we put the knife this way, it will not cut it. If you move the knife this way, it will not cut. There is only one condition, that vegetable x direction, knife y direction, and motion in z direction. Then only it will be cut. So remember, whenever a conductor is cutting a magnetic field, there will be an EMF induced across the conductor. So the same thing happens when a conductor moves. Now an aeroplane is flying. Okay, this is an aeroplane and it is flying this way. See, these are the wings of aeroplane. If they move this way, then there is a vertical component of magnetic field of earth, vertical component. When it moves like this, it is cutting the vertical component. If it is cutting the vertical component, there is an EMF developed between the two ends of the wings of the aeroplane, and it does happen. Now the same thing happens when a train is running. A train is running with a fast speed, v velocity. Okay, two wheels axle. And this is coming in this direction. In this direction. This is vertical component of Earth's magnetic field, B vertical. This is coming in this direction, and this is orientation of the conductor. So all these three are fulfilling the conditions to produce an EMF. So when this axle moves like this, it is cutting the magnetic field of the earth. So an EMF is induced in these two ends. This EMF induced in the two wheels is transmitted to the rails, and from these rails are going to the next station. In the next station, we connect these two rails and bring it to our control room. Now when a train is running, there will be an induced EMF here, and that potential difference, that voltage, is carried to our control room. If the train is not running, it's not moving, there is no train, then there is no potential difference here. So usually there is no potential difference, no light up. The moment a train comes to this track, this light just lights up. And this gives an indication to this person that there is a train coming on the track. And this particular phenomena we use for tracking. This we use for signaling in railways. Okay, so this is how motional EMF is important. Another example of motional EMF is, this is a rod which is moving in the vertical motion, in circular motion, like this. This end is fixed, this end is moving, the length of rod is L. What will be the EMF across these two ends? Okay, we can solve it by two manners. Number one, we know that E is equal to BLV. This particle is moving down, this end is moving down with a certain velocity V. So this is moving down with velocity 0. Then we know that if this conductor is coming down with a velocity V, it has a potential difference equal to BLV, EMF BLV. But here what's happening? This end is coming down, but this is not coming down. There is no problem. Mathematically, we can find out an average. So for a very small fall, for a very small motion, we can find here velocity is 0, here velocity is V, so average velocity. Average velocity is equal to 0 plus V upon 2. That is V upon 2. Therefore, EMF is equal to half BLV. This is EMF across this. And where is the magnetic field? It has to be at right angle. So this is the magnetic field everywhere. This direction or coming out direction. So when this rod rotates, it simply cuts out this. And the moment it cuts out this, there is a potential difference developed. And that is equal to half BLV. Now if it is moving with a angular velocity omega, then we know this omega is related to V. V is equal to L omega. We put this value here, L omega. So EMF developed will be half B L square omega. Yes. So for rotational motion, half B L square omega is the expression. For linear motion, velocity V is given, then this is the formula. Same motion, we have these two formulas. The another method is, if here magnetic field is B, the total area is pi L square is the area. Magnetic field strength is B. Then how much is the flux? Flux is equal to BA, which is equal to B pi L square. Okay. If this starts from here and comes here back, it takes certain time, and that time is, let us say, T. Then what is change in the flux? Change in flux in time T is equal to, it starts from here, put a whole line, this is change in the flux. So what will be the E? Change in the flux divided by change in time. So this is equal to d phi B pi L square divided by time T. Now we have to convert it. What is given to us? Omega. So where is omega here? T is related to omega. How T is related to omega? Omega is equal to 2 pi upon T. This is omega. So T is equal to 2 pi upon omega. This we can put as T is equal to 2 pi upon omega. Pi, pi is cancelled. This omega goes up and it comes to half BL square, and this omega goes up, omega. This is EMF. This minus is opposite direction, but that we can always find out with our right hand, Fleming's right hand rule. So please remember, this is the formula, and this is mostly used. This is given an analogy with spokes in the cycle wheel. Normally it is given to us, a cycle wheel has got 5-10 spokes and it is moving with an angular velocity omega, and length of each spoke is given, the strength of magnetic field is given, and if all these three are given, you can always calculate EMF. That EMF will be across the two points. This is one point and this is another point. So whenever a cycle is moving this way, it has to be in a particular direction, because Earth's magnetic field is always toward north. So our cycle should go in east-west direction. Then only EMF is developed. If the cycle is going in north-south direction, it is not developed. So if a cycle is moving in east-west direction, there is a magnetic field in north direction, it is cutting the magnetic field lines. So here there is a change in the flux, and half BL square omega. This is the EMF in a case of a cycle spoke or cycle. This is axle and this is rim. So EMF between cycle's axle and rim. EMF between cycle's axle and rim is given by this formula. Now one step further. They tell us, find out this EMF. If there are 10 spokes, then how much will be the EMF? And mostly we are tempted to multiply this with 10. But remember, we are not supposed to multiply it with 10, because this EMF, this EMF, this EMF, all are parallel to each other. This and this and this and this and. So it is like cells in parallel combination. Cells in parallel combination. If this has got potential difference V, 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 then what is the potential difference here? Answer, it is V. In parallel, potential difference does not increase. It is the current which is combined. So even if it is one spoke, this is the EMF. If there are 10 spokes, even then, this is the EMF. The total energy, the total charges, the total current will be more, but EMF will not be more. So these are certain examples of motional EMF, and mostly numericals are asked from this section itself. So after this, we will study another thing, that is, if we change the angle theta. We have so far done what for the flux, d phi is change in this B A cos theta. This we have seen, the changes of B, we have seen the changes of A, and one part of this is motional EMF, and now we will see the change in theta, how change in theta occurs to create EMF. Okay, so that we will do in our next lectures.